We'll begin in just a moment, folks. I am getting everything wrapped up here and pulling my notes off the printer, and I'll be turning the camera on and we'll be live, where you can see my pretty face. Hey folks, I hope you can hear me good. Heather will let me know. Heather's here tonight. Again, she was with me last night. And we're giving this away tonight. This right here. Look how pretty. Look how pretty. You can steam hot dogs. And I think, look here, it's 8-dog capacity. Steam and the buns all at one time. We're going to give this away to one lucky commenter, somebody that's watching live right here. Tonight is question night. It's Friday night. Hope you had a great week. We had an awesome webinar last night, and let me do the countdown thingy thing, and we'll get started here. And that way, you know, you have to, professional like me, you have to do this the right way. So here's the countdown. Look at that. I was able to get a sip of my Diet Pepsi. May have had a tad of rum in it. Can't be for sure. But here's the deal. We have an awesome night planned. We have questions that have been submitted. We are. I'm going to talk about the hot dog cart giveaway, two of them, in less than 60 days. And we have the vendor of the week. We have an announcement. We have all kinds of cool stuff. It's just crazy, okay? So I've got three computer screens going right now. And so if you see me look over here and look over here, I'm not ignoring you, okay? I'm looking you in your eyes like my dad used to tell me. Look me in my eyes, son. So you'll see this thing right here, this thing, change as I talk about different stuff. Maybe, if I can get it to work. So, I'm glad you're here, and we'll get started. So, the vendor of the week, I'm excited about the vendor of the week, Mickey Wheeler, okay? His menu includes bacon jam. If you don't know what bacon jam is, you need to go to learnhotdogs.com and just search bacon jam in the search box. You can get the recipe for free, thanks to Jason Brown. There have been hundreds of vendors using that on their cart now because it is freaking awesome. That is like my Coke onions, but even better because it's got bacon. You can, bacon jam is like, you could put that on roadkill and it doesn't matter how long the roadkill's been there. So it just gets better. Now, if you're seeing behind me and it looks like a mess, it is. This is my little green room studio, us professionals have. And so I have a whiteboard back there clipped with my green screen. Okay. I'm like, this is high tech redneck stuff. I don't know if you'd be able to understand all my videography lingo. But I'm excited you're here. I'm glad you're here, and we're gonna get going here. Let's see. We have the vendor of the week. I said is Mickey Wheeler. You can go visit him. He's on the page here. He's on the page. You'll see it in the profile picture, wherever that is. Maybe there, maybe here. Not sure, because I get turned around when I'm watching myself. So, anyway, you'll be able to see that. I think it's right there. Okay? So, you can go visit him, though, at Big Mick Hot Dogs. That's facebook.com/ Big Mick Hot Dogs. Congratulations to Mickey Wheeler. And awesome for your bacon jam. We'd love to see some pictures, and we expect it. You won, so we expect some pictures. It's kind of like we win. I love seeing pictures of y'all's food. It is just awesome. Okay, tonight, though, we're going to give away Booyah this. Shipped free, okay? You saw this before. We've already given away one of these. We're giving away another one, okay? Holds up to 8 hot dogs, steams the buns and the dogs at one time. Great for, you know, you got your kids, you know, an easy, cool thing to use, or your grandkids over and you want to make some hot dogs and make it look cool. It's kind of a nostalgic looking little steamer thing. It's freaking awesome. And I'd love for you to check that out. The other thing I want to tell you about is maybe I have the wrong one. Oh, you want to know about winning a cart, okay? Here's how you can win a cart. It's right here, okay? And I'll leave this up for a while, okay? I'm not going to go into a long explanation. All you do is text Cater Pro, the words Cater Pro, to 44222, okay? And you're entered. If you get a text back immediately, you know you did it right. If you don't, then you didn't do it right. So, that's all you got to do there. Later, I'm going to give you another text number to text for even more goodness. So, let's see here. I've got questions and from people that have submitted them, and I'm going to answer them. Heather's made me a list, and I'm going to go through these real quick. And then, if you have a question and we have time, put it down here in the comments, and I'll answer it live. But you have to be here live. It's our little catch. So here's the deal. Question from the Hot Dogs Facebook page. Okay, that's the Ben's Carts page. Been up and running now for about 3 months. Been very slow. Permit process is hell in Louisiana. They have $100 you do death. Finally have a show. 3 vendors for 4,000 people. I've got a couple of questions. How large of an ice chest do you use and still be able to carry it? And 2, does anyone use coleslaw on their dogs? And that's the only questions. Oh, if so, do you make your own or have a favorite premix? Thanks much. Happy slinging from Ray in Lafayette, Louisiana. Ray, great questions. Okay, let's start at the beginning because this has some variables. Okay, this has some things that we can't control and we don't know the information to be able to plug in the data. But you said you have a show, you're doing an event, okay, and it's 3 vendors for 4,000 people, and you want to know how large of an ice chest do you carry. Typically at events, an ice truck will be on standby, okay, but if there's not one, you may want to call. They may drop you off an ice chest for you for free, and then charge you for only what you use out of it. I don't know if you know about that, but they do that. If they don't do that, or you don't have a ice company that offers that service, then you can go to an ice company or go to the grocery store and buy ice, okay? I would not go with huge coolers where I couldn't carry the ice. What I would do is set up ahead of time, pre-set up, put coolers out and fill it full of ice. How much ice depends on how many people you're going to need ice for. I mean, I don't know. And you say 3 vendors, 4,000 people. There's weather variables. There's all these variables. There's a variable where you're located in the event. But let's assume, best case scenario, you're going to get about 12 to 1,500 of those customers, right? So you'd have to have 12 to 1,500 drinks. I assume that's what you're using your ice for. That's a lot of freaking drinks. Me, I always underestimate, because I like selling out and I like going home early. I don't worry about, oh, I coulda, woulda, shoulda made more. I don't worry about it. If I sell 400 meals, I'm tickled pink. That's 800 hot dog gone. See you later. Bye. I'm fishing with money in my pockets. You can try to capitalize on every bit of it as long as you have the storage and the area to put it in. I went into more detail on last night's video, and it should be right down there. Literally, right down there. You should be able to go and watch that, because I go into a lot of detail on a similar question I got last night about an event. So that will help you. Now, the other question you asked is, and also as far as how much can you carry, I get one of those wagons, and you can go to Ace Hardware, you can go to Lowe's, you can go to Amazon.com, and they sell those. They're called garden wagons. It's like a metal base, little tiny sides, and you can stack mulch up on it or ice coolers, and you tote it, and it'll go through the sand, it'll go through rock, it'll go through up a hill, grass, whatever, because it's just these big rubber air wheels. And they don't get bogged down in sand and stuff. They're great. I did a wedding and I pulled one down to the beach through the sand, and they work great. Coleslaw on their dogs. Absolutely, people use coleslaw. I think that it's illegal to not sell or offer a hot dog in the state of North Carolina without slaw. North Carolina has what's called the Carolina slaw dog, which is chili, but the ground up tiny, like minced chili, okay? Chili like you'd eat chili bean chili with slaw on top. They even, some of the fast food restaurants, McDonald's, Wendy's, Hardee's, those companies will actually offer in North Carolina a chili slaw dog. It's called a Carolina slaw dog. So you might want to check about that. As far as a recipe, I make things simple on myself. There's a lot of good slaws out there. Okay, you can go to the grocery store. You can talk to the grocery manager and go, hey, I want to buy 5 gallons of coleslaw or 25 gallons of coleslaw. Can you cut me a break? He'll probably say yes. If you start doing these regularly, you can go to somebody like US Foods or Sysco and buy it in bulk. Bulk coleslaw. If you don't like the flavor, coleslaw is easy to change. Easy as heck. You can add a little cumin to it. You can add a little paprika to it. You can add a little bit of cayenne to it. You can add a little garlic to it. You can add a little honey to it, brown sugar to it. Not all these at once. I'm just saying, you can add these things to it and kind of taste test it and go, oh, that's good. Because typically, the normal coleslaw at a restaurant is pretty crappy, unless it's a mom and pop where they make it themselves. You can turn about any coleslaw, because all it is ground up cabbage and mayonnaise, basically, okay, a little bit of vinegar sometimes or pickle juice, and you end up with coleslaw. So go online, look at some of the recipes, look at the rated recipes. I love this website called allrecipes.com, and they have ratings, and it'll tell me, oh, this is a winner. And it'll tell me how many stars it got, how many people reviewed it. And I go, oh, I'm going to try that. And then I try it and I go, well, that could use a little more brown sugar. And I add a little brown sugar to it and taste it. Let other people taste it. And they go, oh, this is good. Where'd you get this? Well, I made it. And you did. You made it. It's your recipe now because you just added something to it. You jacked it up. So look at doing that to your recipe. Heather, if you need anything, I do have Skype up. If there's something that comes up, I need to answer. I'm going to put up another. Oh, remember now, folks, if you're tuning in, we're giving this away. You got to stay in to win. Heather's going to pick a winner, but you got to be here. The other day, people left before we could give it away, so nobody got it. So hopefully somebody gets it. We also have the thing down here, this text Cater Pro to the number 44222, and you could win a hot dog cart, a Cater Pro cart, the bad butt cart, okay? Just like that. I'm going to change this, though, real quick, because We have another thing you can text, and you'll get updates. I don't send many of these out, so you're not going to get bombarded from me, and they're usually voice messages. So it'll be me on the phone going, "Hey, Charlie," or "Hey, Rhonda, there's I'm doing a special something schism frozen, and you need to be there, or you may want to be there, or we're giving this away or giving that away." We have an incredible announcement November 1st, okay? It's actually going to be announced tomorrow. So it'll be announced tomorrow in the Vendors United group, and then later it will be announced on the blog. And this is the end-all, be-all. This is what a lot of people love. I've done this for four or five years now. It starts November 1st, but I'm announcing it early. So be watching for that tomorrow, okay? There will be some announcements on Facebook and the Twitters and the blog. And if you get my email, you'll probably get it first. Or if you go here, you'll get it before anybody. Right here. Booyah! You get it before anybody. And the nice part is, this isn't one of those things, well, Ben, it doesn't matter if I got it before somebody else. Well, it kind of does when you see this. Because it's a limited quantity thing. So, anyway, so that's what we have. Street Food Pro, just so you know, that's the hat. Street Food Pro hat. And we give those out to members from time to time. We'll pick out, 40 members and send them out. So, if you're not a member, go to vendorsunited.com, join, and you'll see. You can quit at any time. So, it's the best thing ever. It's better than sliced bread. Because I can pull apart my bread, and I'd rather be a part of the Street Food Protein. Now, question from Learn Hot Dogs blog. Okay? If you haven't been there, go there. LearnHotDogs.com. Top 10 winter vending tips. Okay? We did a winter vending tips. I say we, and I use that word very liberally. Heather did a blog article, The Winter Vending Tips, okay? And it says, "I am possibly interested in winter vending but live where temps are below freezing. How do I meet health department requirements of hand washing station if the pipes on my cart freeze?" Well, guess what? They won't freeze. If you get the right kind of cart, your pipes won't freeze. Not if you're running your cart. Now, when you end the day, you may want to drain, pump your lines dry, drain it, and then go, okay? Because we have vendors in Canada, we have vendors in Alaska, we have vendors in other countries where it stays freaking cold. Stays cold, okay? So, it isn't an issue. It isn't an issue with the health department, because if your water's working, you'll be fine. And we can show you how to make your water work. It's not rocket science. It's just a matter of the right hookups. It's like, have you ever been in town and saw an RV? Well, how did that RV keep their water lines from freezing? There you go. So, Mark, that's a great question, though. It is a great question. I get vendors call me. I had a call today from Alberta, Canada. And the guy was asking me about the, I got two calls from Canada today, but Alberta, Canada, he was asking me about how, working in the cold. What do you do? How do you do that? How do you put up with that? It's pretty easy if you have the right stuff, okay? And I filmed vendors doing it. Personally been there, filmed them. You see me, you see them. And you can find that at learnhotdogs.com. But there's a 10 winter tips over there at the blog, learnhotdogs.com. Check it out. I hope that helps, Mark. If I didn't answer your question good enough, please let me know, and I'll be happy to go further. Possibly, Heather asked if my notes were covering my microphone. I don't know where my microphone is on this computer. So it could have been covering my microphone. I hope you heard that well enough to hear it, or do I need to redo it? Can you let me know, Heather? I'm waiting on Heather, if you're wondering what I'm doing. She's going to tell me whether I need to redo this section. If it didn't come through good. Okay. She says it's good, so we're good. Next. I think that's it. I think we're done, other than a winner. But I will tell you, I'm going to recap just a couple things. Huge announcement tomorrow. Hopefully you get my emails. Hopefully you get or you sign up to hear. This is the quickest way, right here. I'm going to send you a voicemail tomorrow, and it's going to tell you everything, and then it's going to tell you where to go, and it is huge, and you'll want to know first. You'll want to know first, okay? If you would like to win a cart, we give it away. There's no catch. There's no gimmicks like, oh, you win, but you got to pay for this, this. No, you win the cart, fully loaded, ready to go, okay? We are going to give that away in December. We're giving away another cart on December 1st. You want to know any of this stuff? Either join my email list or do this right here that's scrolling across the screen. You punch in this number, 292929, as a phone number. Pretend it's a phone number. And then put in the word street food, as your message. That's it. And then you're done. So we're going to give this away. And guess who won it? I just got the message. I love this randomizer thing. We have a randomizer. It like picks a winner for us so that we don't have to feel bad because we didn't pick the right person, blah, blah, blah. We just grab all the names, put it in there, and it goes, bloop, picks one. Okay, winner is Blake Huey. Here's all you got to do. All you got to do is send an email, okay, to support@vendorsunited.com with your name, address, and I don't even need your phone number. Name and address. I'm going to mail this sucker to you, okay? Actually, somebody else is going to do it for me, but it's going to come to you. And I'm going to get this out to you. Congratulations, Blake Huey. It may be Hoy. Blake Hoy. I hope I didn't butcher that up too bad. I apologize if I did. Just consider me a hillbilly and go, I'll give him a pass. He's kind of not all there. And you'd be a lot correct. So if there's no, is there any other questions or anything, Heather, do we have anything else that I need to do, before we close out? I'm waiting. There's a lag. I don't know if you know this. There's a lag. Like, I'm doing this, and then there's like a lag before you hear what I'm doing. And so I'm waiting, and I'm just making sure there's no... We're all good. I got the all thumbs up. We're all good. I love you. I hope you have a fantastic freaking weekend. Thank you, Heather, for being awesome and for doing this. And congratulations to Blake. And I'm not even going to try the last name. And we will have some fun this tomorrow. I'm going to send you messages tomorrow. So you're going to want to do that number thing I had down a minute ago because it is the bomb. Y'all have a fantastic weekend. All right? Be looking for stuff from me. This kind of stuff. You ready? All right. We'll see you later.